Using a lubricant should be fun and safe. Today, we talk to the amazing expert and founder of Glissant, Dr. Elber. Here, we cover her amazing FDA-approved water-based lubricant, as well as her CBD-infused oil-based lubricant. Hi, my name is Laura Meyhoffer, and on this channel, I help you gain optimal movement through knowledge and health. Have the amazing Dr. Elber to answer all of our lubricant questions and get to know more about her and her amazing company's background.
So I don't want to spend too much time just on me because I want to be able to talk about what's important while we're here today. But I'm actually a urologist and I went into urology because I really liked working with women and I liked gynecology, but quite frankly, I didn't want to get up in the middle of the night to deliver babies. And then and the other reason why I liked gynecology was I knew that there was this subspecialty of female pelvic medicine, and that's what I really wanted to do. And after I finished my fellowship training in that, I really started realizing that there is a huge void, as you know, for women and sexual function and without being marginalized and with really good treatments that we know are there, but are not really known or available to a lot of women. And so as an offshoot of that, also a lot I heard was, you know, what's a good lubricant to use? Because I have, you know, pain with intercourse, you know, I was all of what, early 30s, and I didn't really know much about them. And then when I started really thinking about it, you know, and started looking on the market, just a lot of products with chemicals and or different things that, you know, are not really friendly for the vaginal area. And so that's how I kind of started down that journey. And then my co-founder, who is one of my friends and former patients, she's actually in the beauty industry. And she'd always been telling me in the background, you really should think about making some kind of product. And I'm like, what would I possibly make as a doctor? Right. So it all worked out perfectly. And because I'm a doctor, I also wanted to get FDA, you know, clearance for the product. And while we were spending time doing that, unfortunately, her sister got sick with brain cancer. And the only thing that helped her pain was CBD. And so she said, you know, if we're really trying to help women with pain with sex, why not make a product that had CBD? And keep in mind, this was several years ago before it was all legalized. And it was still, you know, the idea of, you know, cannabis or CBD was, you know, some kind of tree hugging, you know, wake and bake kind of person. And so, you know, I was very much out of my comfort zone until I started really, you know, doing my research and finding out all the possible benefits. So fast forward, here we are. And, you know, on social media, obviously, I found you because there's just not a lot of, or there's more now, but there's not a lot of physical therapists who specialize in pelvic floor physical therapy, which I think is extremely important, is, you know, again, how I found you.
Yes. So Glissant love to find these amazing products. And you sent some of them to me. And I love them because the packaging is very discreet. So you can actually see them behind you right now. And it almost looks like a beautiful perfume bottle, which I think is so awesome because a lot of times we have to travel with these items. We just don't know when sexy time's going to happen, you know? And so being able to carry that discreetly, I think is like one of the first things I was like, oh, this is so great because it doesn't have to be ugly. It can be beautiful.
Right. It doesn't have to look like your toothpaste tube.
Yes.
And I don't know if you realize also, it's actually refillable. So you can actually take out and refill it. So that's why, you know, it seems like, why, you know, why use this or waste this beautiful product on the outside? But you can actually just get the refills also.
Yes, which I think is so awesome and totally eco-friendly, which I'm like a huge, huge fan of. What does the product line entail? Because I think maybe that will help too if anyone has any questions about how we might use these products or anything like that. Maybe outline first what it is.
Yeah. So just to a little broader aspect. Yeah. So people will use lubricants really for one of two reasons. One is just a medical necessity. They're just too dry and intercourse is painful. And then there's, of course, people who just like it for recreational purposes, just kind of enhance what's going on. But, you know, our natural lubrication should occur And it's also under the influence of hormones. So that's why most premenopausal women should not have a problem. However, lots of medications, including birth control, sometimes antihistamines, other things that dry you out, or if you've had prior surgeries there, will affect the lubrication. So in order for lubrication to occur also, you have to have good blood flow to the pelvis. So that's why the ingredients in the lubricants not only lubricate you, but they will actually enhance your own natural lubrication, ideally. And then there's also in the FDA cleared one, you know, it's got lactic acid, and you may not realize, but our vagina actually is acidic normally. And that's what helps prevent us from getting infections all the time. So our own good bacteria, if you will, actually make, believe it or not, lactic acid and hydrogen peroxide. So we're like a self-cleaning oven. Yeah. You know, it's interesting. We get these like health classes maybe in junior high and high school, which are very basic. And then the rest you're kind of left up to finding out on your own if you ever find out. Right. And one of the focuses also of our company is really just education. It's really hard for women to go to one place and get reliable, accurate information about their lady parts because, number one, as you know, nobody wants to talk about it. Right. And number two, you know, people tend to look at it, it's either porn, right? Yes. Or it's like, or it's super clinical. There's not really like a normal conversation about it. And then the CBD product, like I was mentioning earlier, you know, it's really, especially for that woman who has pain within her cords, because you get to enjoy all the benefits of CBD. Mm-hmm. We also added CBG, which a lot of people are not familiar with, but it's kind of the newer kid on the block, and it works. It actually kind of potentiates the effects of CBD. Wow. And also what's interesting is CBD and CBG have natural anti-infective properties. So if a woman has pain and is prone to infections, it's also a good choice.
Oh, that's awesome.
What we specifically do not have in our products, so glycerin is what you're thinking about because it's like a sugar that potentially can feed the yeast, if you will. There's no phthalates, you know, there's no propylene glycol, no silicones, lots of things where fortunately most women, their vagina is pretty resilient and so doesn't get affected. But, you know, women who especially are prone to pain within her course, and then you throw in an infection, it's like, what's the motivation to ever have sex again?
Right. So you have the two different products. Is there one that you recommend individuals start with from your company? Or do you think it's good to kind of go with both? Or...
Well, it's really what the specific need is. So no oil-based lubricant is really condom compatible. So if a woman's using condoms, she should just stay away from that one. Just doesn't really make any sense. Theoretically, if you have a severe nut allergy, you also might not want to do the CBD one because there's some coconut oil in it. But other than that, and also some women also just prefer a water-based one, again, because of lubricants, compatibility with condoms, and that actually has been specifically tested in the FDA cleared one. So, you know, it really depends. And, you know, honestly, you can even mix the two if you want like a totally different experience.
Can either of these be utilized as almost a moisturizer? Because I know that's something that people really, really struggle with is that lack of moisture.
Yes, you can potentially use, I would say if you're going to do it on a daily basis, the water-based one is probably better because you just don't want to build up too much oil inside the vaginal canal, but you could also alternate them, but it's a good point you're making. That's one of the things in the future to make as a daily moisturizer. But again, you have to be really careful that you maintain the normal vaginal flora, like you mentioned earlier. So again, I think daily, probably the water-based one, you know, and you could also alternate with the oil-based one as well.
Okay, that's really great to know. The sea salt caramel is like so cool. I love that. Now tell us more about that.
So my co-founder has much more experience in this area. So she was probably the one who kind of curated that flavor, if you will. But we went back and forth with so many different ones because you don't want the scent too strong and you don't want the taste too sweet. You know, I had some friends saying, oh, you should make it like bacon flavored. I'm like, gross. You know, it's funny when you ask people for their opinions, you're like, maybe I should have asked.
You're like, why did I ask this?
And, you know, we also looked at what were the most popular flavors. So that's how we came with the sea salt and caramel. But also even if you, you know, we were considering like vanilla and all the other ones that are much more common. But once we sat down, actually tasted them and smelled them, this was just the one that I mean, literally from the first time we opened the container, like, this is it.
Yes, yes. Does the sea salt and caramel not add to messing with your pH, or is it a chemical additive?
It's not a chemical. It's actually food grade, and it does not affect the pH because that's what we have the lactic acid in there for. So it's all, when it was formulated, it all took that consideration. So the actual pH of the formula is around 4.2.
Oh, awesome. And so what is the pH of the vagina?
Normally between 3.8 and 4.2.
Awesome. Kind of utilizing these lubricants to assist in that elasticity piece of things.
Well, unfortunately, no lubricant is going to help with the elasticity, but the lubricant can help this woman ideally be more sexually active. So it's kind of like, you know, you do yoga, right? Mm-hmm. So the more that you stretch, the more the tissue will change. So what happens with women, unfortunately, is this vicious cycle that if intercourse hurts, they avoid it. So if you're only having sexual activity once a month, that's like doing yoga once a month. You're never going to get to where you are. So what the lubricant could be ideal for, and I would strongly recommend probably the CBD version of it, mm-hmm. she can actually buy vaginal dilators from Amazon. You probably realize mm-hmm. that. And what she can do is gradually dilate herself in between sexual activity and use lots of lubricant. And then when she gets the size of dilator that is close to her partner, then she can try sexual activity. But the other thing that happens, which is what you take care of, is if a woman knows it's going to hurt, she clenches up everything. Mm-hmm. So sometimes it's not elasticity so much as it's not relaxation of the muscles. And so the longer she goes without pain, she won't reflexively contract her pelvic floor.
Mm-hmm. Completely, completely. I enjoy about your product and recommending it to people is it has like the little spray applicator. And so again, it's something beautiful that they can leave out. It's discreet. Their kids don't know what it is. They can spritz it on their fingers. They can utilize it to stretch those tissues so that it's something that is a fun experience versus looking at, like you said, a toothpaste tube of lube or another kind of bottle of lube that has some weird smell. We want to engage as much as we can to help gain that relaxation. And I think that's what sets your product apart from other people's, and then what helps individuals stay engaged in their home program to help with that.
Absolutely. And you took the words out of my mouth. I was going to suggest, because the spray is nice, because you could just spray the dilator, you know, in a nice uniform way. And also, and like you said, rubbing it on the opening. And what I'd recommend for this woman is applying the CBD product like vaginally, let it sit for a little bit and then do the dilation. Because I think the longer you have the topical CBD, probably the better it will work.
How long does it take after applying the CBD product for it to start to take effect / ease pain?
You know, it depends on how much you use, of course. But most people, like if you start out with foreplay with it, you got a good, you know,
yes,
hopefully a good 10, yes, 15 minutes. And that should be plenty because it's, you know, the vagina actually will absorb things relatively well topically. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's not going to work like within a few seconds, but
right,
I would
right.
say, you know, a good 10 minutes is probably a good amount of time.
A sufficient amount of time. Yeah. I think that's, the biggest thing, and again, why I keep going back to my love of the product packaging and the spray, is that we want it to be, you want it to be something that is easily, I always think of things that can be put into people's lives versus their lives having to change to fit that thing in. And so it's something that can sit on your bedside table and you would never know, no one would ever be the wiser of what is that that's sitting on your table. It could be pillow, like lavender pillow spray for all they know, you know? And so I really, really love that. So that as foreplay starts, it's something you can incorporate straight away And then by the time actual penetration or whatever is going, it's been, like you said, that 10 to 15 minutes. So you've had that good warm-up time. And then, like you said, time for it to really absorb in.
Now, I think it's wonderful. Again, there's just so few places that women can go to get good, reliable information. And I don't know if you've noticed or you really look at the ingredients in the CBD product, but we also worked with an herbologist to get a lot of the natural aphrodisiacs. And, you know, you can get a lot of products that have these individual ingredients, but the talent of the herbologist is knowing how to get these herbs to work together. Nice. So that's what's so great too, is they've actually got some aphrodisiac type properties as well.
If they're using the CBD, will it also affect their male partner physically during sex?
I guess without clarifying, affect the male partner one way. I mean, I suppose the skin on the outside of the penis is probably a little bit thicker than the mm-hmm. vagina. So they potentially also could get some of the benefits of CBD, but the reality is the vaginal benefits of the CBD are helping increase blood flow, helping with pain, and the blood flow for the penis isn't coming from just the topical part of that as opposed to internally for the vagina for a woman. So, I mean, except for maybe having some of the lubricant benefits of it, mm-hmm. I doubt the male will have as much benefit as the woman will.
Right. Right. So it wouldn't necessarily result in having like an erectile dysfunction Correct. Type experience. Right. And I think the other thing that is important to note, and some individuals might not know this, and obviously you can speak way more to this than I can, but the inside of the vaginal canal is like a mucosa. So yes. I always explain it's like the inside of your mouth yes. versus the skin on like the outside of my lips. So maybe that's something you could explain to our audience a little bit.
Yes. So that's why sometimes you can get medications that are vaginal suppositories because, right, the lining of the vagina, it's a good analogy you used, absorb is it better as opposed to, right, the skin of the penis would be more like the skin on the outside. So it just won't absorb things as well. Mm-hmm. So that's a perfect example.
Yes.
Even when a man or woman wants to know something, you know, typically when you come to the doctor's office, right, we're ticking off the most acute problems. And so not that your sexual wellness, of course, isn't important, but, you know, by the time you're done with all the other issues, few people actually make an appointment specifically for sexual function. A, I think they're embarrassed about it. So B, they might want to mention on the tail end, but then you're like, oh, time's up. Thanks. You know, see you next time. Yeah. So, and also, you can only discuss sexual wellness when you're comfortable with your own sexuality. Mm-hmm. And so not all people, physicians included, are comfortable discussing mm-hmm. it. So I think it's great that there is much more forums like this where people can openly discuss and we normalize sex in whatever way that, you know, someone considers their sexuality normal. We marginalize a lot of things that society does not necessarily consider normal.
Right. Right. Being able to have that ability to do solo exploration, which is, I think, really amazing, too. Having that CBD to get that relaxation of those muscles and those vaginal tissues to then be able to explore masturbation and what that might look like for you will then only enrich it. Enrich the experience with another partner, you know, explore yourself yes. and what feels good.
You know, it's interesting you say that. Our fellow who's a trainee with us recently just wrote a little paper about using vibrators to help sexual health, because the bottom line is for men and women, like I mentioned earlier, you have to have good pelvic blood flow. And that's why some men actually will use a daily medication to help with their erectile function. Mm-hmm. So theoretically, using something like a vibrator on a daily basis can help increase blood flow and help pelvic health. But again, these are things where, you know, we say, oh, you use a vibrator? Like, what's wrong mm-hmm. with you? You must be some kind of a dirty girl. So right. you know, hopefully with, you know, just more education and putting things like vibrators in a different context than just what people have always considered like pornographic will actually help people.
Totally. Is the product waterproof?
Well, the water-based one is not going to be waterproof. Correct. Of course, it's going to wash off a little easier. Mm-hmm. And the CBD one, it's not as thick as, say, you know, silicones or thicker type of oils. So it will clean off easier. But if you want something that is, you know, water, closer to waterproof, it'd be the oil. But you don't want something that's totally waterproof, otherwise you won't be able to ever wash it off of anything.
Correct. When we talk about the water-based and oil-based and silicone-based, so Glissant has a water-based product, an oil-based product. Those are the two products. When I am thinking for recommending a product to a patient or to friends or whomever to this community, if you are, typically what you have heard me say is, if you are going to be using some type of vibrator, some type of intimacy aid that that's made of silicone, you will never use a silicone lubricant with a silicone toy. So the nice thing about Glissant is you don't have to worry about that. You can have both products in your bedside table and you're not going to worry about that interacting poorly with any of your vibrators.
That's right.
Because, which for me, I think is really nice. It gives me a sense of safety because if I'm in the heat of the moment and I go to grab for a lubricant and I may be using some type of vibrator, it kind of like dampens the mood to be like, wait, which lubricant is this? Versus having like Glissant products right there, it's nice to know, okay, it doesn't matter which one we grab because any of them will be safe for the toys that I at least have. So I think that that's a really important differentiation to make.
Yep, exactly. You know, the other thing we were kind of talking about earlier also, just like when you're getting ready for anything, whether it's shampoo or lipstick, like you just can't help feeling good about yourself when it's, you know, a pretty package. So that's the other thing that's kind of nice is it just kind of elevates the whole experience. So again, you're not just squeezing lubricant out of some, you know, plastic tube or something.
Yes. Yes, exactly. So if you have something that's not the vagina kind of can't get rid of. And so when we think of silicone is the ones where is more of the product that has that longevity. The concern again is that's staying in there. That's not our body can't get rid of that. And that's where the concern is with, okay, are we going to have infection? Are we going to have this? Are we going to have that? So again, that's the nice thing with Glissant is you're not going to have those concerns that you typically would have with some other products.
Well, because, you know, not a lot of people take interest in sexual wellness, or if they do, it's not really sexual wellness per se, you know, it's
more
some other agenda.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. I love hearing who was on the team to make these products. And I think the audience will really find this interesting. So you were highlighting the herbologist and that not only are the things that are in this product, like aphrodisiacs, they're also good for our system. So I just want to highlight and say that is like really, really awesome. So who are some of the other unique members that were on this team? I mean, one, having a physician actually who knows the area and like is making it, I think is huge. And then when you said the herbologist, I was like, whoa, that's so incredible.
So the FDA cleared product was really just myself and my co-founder. And the ingredients I picked really were based on some of the more common problems that women have. So, you know, hyaluronic acid is a naturally occurring humectant, right? And again, lactic acid, anything that would promote the acidity to help prevent infections and keep the vaginal health normally. And of course, to remain compliant with the FDA, there was some limitations. So that one was pretty straightforward, at least for me, because I've been doing this for a while. But yeah, when we started doing the CBD product, we honestly just by sheer luck got connected to this herbologist, and she is fantastic, Dr. Janelle Kim. Her family has literally centuries old proprietary recipes for all sorts of different, you know, herbology mixes. And so she's the one who's, you know, she knew exactly what we wanted. We met with her, and I think she had already thought about this beforehand because when we met with her, she knew exactly what she wanted to add. Wow. So it's pretty cool. So a lot of the natural ingredients increase, you know, they promote increase in blood flow. Mm-hmm. And again, they work together. So, you know, you can, and you know from your practice, right? We know the individual effects of things, but what we don't realize is when you mix things together. So for instance, the CBD and the CBG, they call this like this quote unquote entourage effect, where you really get more of the effect of each individual ingredient when you put them together.
Nice.
The clitoris is actually equivalent to the penis. So those little legs that you were referring to, right, are equal to what we call the crura that are inside of the penis, which is why when you have increased blood flow, you know, many women might have wondered, like, wait, did I feel more swollen like during sexual activity? That is true. And that is normal. And that is the increased blood flow that helps you to lubricate and to feel everything better during sexual activity.
Mm-hmm. So what are some things for women that will decrease that blood flow? Is it solely hormonal changes? Is it medications, age?
Yes, and yes. So one very common thing would be with menopause, when there's not enough estrogen, you just don't have as much blood flow down there. Sometimes prior surgeries, like if a woman's had a hysterectomy, you know, sometimes those blood vessels can get cut. Sometimes it's honestly just lack of arousal. Like you have to be aroused in order for you to have, you know, an actual physiologic response. Mm-hmm. So again, it's back to if a woman knows she's going to have pain with intercourse, even if it's the perfect mood, she can't possibly like, so you can actually have, you know, be in the mood and have good libido and not have normal arousal just because it's hard to get turned on and have that response when it's perfect, but you know, you just know it's not going to feel good. So it just doesn't quite happen.
Right. Exactly. People are listening to this. If you fall into these categories, or maybe you're approaching a category, you can be proactive by utilizing really good products to help counteract some of these things that either just occur because of age.
You can have libido, right? Like, so if an attractive person or something, you know, causes you to actually get an interest in sexual activity, but you might not actually get arousal because you just don't really finish the feeling, if you will.
Yes. Where can that perimenopause, menopause range start for people? Because I certainly have had people in their 30s that are starting to talk to me and I'm like, ooh.
Well, you know, one common culprit that a lot of people don't realize is when you're on a very low dose birth control pill over many years, it can actually cause perimenopausal symptoms. And so that's why a young woman can still experience vaginal dryness because, you know, young women, right, should have pretty big hormonal fluctuations. When you're on a low dose birth control pill all the time, you know, the reason you don't get pregnant when you're on the pill is it basically turns your ovaries off. Right. Mm-hmm. So if you're not having these hormonal fluctuations, it's like me only giving you a couple drops of water every day and never giving you a full glass to drink. Mm-hmm. So that's a very common reason. It's pretty unusual to have like a primary ovarian failure. It can happen.
Right.
But usually like your periods would totally stop. You just wouldn't be experiencing like dryness. But, you know, perimenopause it's not terribly unusual to start like in your late 30s, early 40s, which is why it's much more difficult for a woman to become pregnant, you know, after the age of 35 versus 30, and, you know, almost near impossible without help at the age of 45 or over. Mm-hmm. And perimenopause, you know, I mean, just by definition, when someone is again in their, you know, late 40s, even if they're having regular cycles, you know, they're perimenopausal. That's why they can't get pregnant.
Right.
The other thing to kind of throw in there, especially for, you know, sexually active young women who have multiple partners, is when you do have dryness, you're more prone to actually tearing, which potentially can cause like more sexually transmitted infections, you know, if a condom's not being used. So in addition to just, you know, making sex less painful, there actually are like benefits in terms of potentially preventing infections.
Lubricant not only is helpful to enjoy the sexual experience, but also, like you said, it can be protective against STIs, which is so huge and something that is so not talked about. So when you are thinking about using one of Dr. Elber's products, if you are going to use a condom, you want to use the water-based lubricant, and that will help to not only allow for that sliding and gliding, decrease that friction so that you're not having little micro tears, which can then lead to more STI exposure. If the CBD can be helpful during menstruation to ease any aching because of menstrual cramps, which for me, I guess my menstrual cramps tend to feel more in my stomach and not my vagina. So I'm not sure if you've had experience with any patients sharing about that.
I have actually had someone tell me that they kind of soaked their tampon.
Oh, nice.
I mean, just putting it inside for a little bit, it's going to come right out, right? Because you're menstruating.
Yes.
But
yes,
you could potentially just kind of coat the tampon in the CBD to get the effect of that. But you're right, just depends on, I don't know how much you'll actually get in the uterus, but it's, you know, it's certainly worth a try. You're not going to harm yourself. But I think the only way that really makes sense to do that would be to just kind of soak the tampon with it.
Yes. I always like to tell people, create your own toolbox of things to help in whatever your experience is, whatever your goal is that you're trying to help, whether you struggle with menopausal symptoms like vaginal atrophy, whether you have painful periods, low libido issues or partnered issues, whatever it is, try to get together this toolbox of things that will assist you. Both Glissant products can be extremely helpful in all of those cases and are really a must-have for that toolbox.
Each individual lubricant really should be based on what a woman needs.
Right.
And I think this age group is probably a little bit younger, probably still using condoms, you know, so, you know, reinforcing that the water-based one is best for use with condoms.
Right. Right. So have you had people kind of seek you out for your expertise because they found out, oh, this is the Glissant founder, one of the founders, and then finding you through to work with you through that avenue? Or
there's been some, but, you know, I don't know if you realize we actually only launched at the end of March. So it was, you know, we had plans for like a big launch, but of course the pandemic occurred and we really made a very soft launch at that point because neither my co-founder or I felt comfortable. You know, you just didn't really want to try to make a splash when there was so much, not that sexual wellness, again, like you were saying, is important, but just compared to like a potentially life-threatening virus, it just seemed like a little disrespectful to do that.
Important thing is to really show your expertise and the fact that this company was founded by an individual who has been a tried and tested physician, which is, to me as a provider, when I'm recommending products, is really, really, really important. You're just not a face that they purchased, you know, while they were out and about. It's that you were in it, developing it, doing all these things. So how long have you been practicing?
Well, if I say, it's going to be a big indicator of my age, but I actually finished my fellowship in 2002. So I actually graduated medical school in 1995. So it's kind of like you had a long road for yours.
Yes.
So it's, you know, 4 years of medical school, 6 years of residency, additional training as a fellow. So I've been in practice almost 20 years.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And again, I think that's the things to me that are very important and speak to the fact that this isn't just some product that was thrown together. It's something that really came together with a lot of thought and care to the needs of your patients and through many, many years of experience of seeing this area of the body and knowing what people struggle with day in and day out. And that to me is something that is just as important as a beautiful package, an eco-friendly package, and all of those things, is knowing that there's that FDA approval for one of the products, and that that it's really created by someone who knows that area.
I love that you appreciate that. It's kind of like, you know, I was looking at your website, reading your story, right? You don't really plan on doing this stuff. It kind of happens. Well, it happens because you see a need and you feel strongly about it. So again, it's like years of having women ask, what's a good lubricant? And I'm like, you know, I don't want to say any names, but you know, you kind of have the same thing roll off your tongue. You're like, I can do better than that, you know? And then when right. you have the good fortune of having a friend who's in that industry and says, hey, we can do this. Mm-hmm. And you know, the FDA clearance, yes, was a big deal for me. You don't have to have lubricants FDA cleared, but I wanted women to have that sense of reassurance. And, you know, people often will ask, well, why isn't the CBD product FDA cleared? There is no FDA clearance for any CBD right. products at this right. point. That's why there is. But, you know, again, all of the love and care went into the CBD product that went to the FDA product.
Right. And I would say arguably with CBD stuff, because it can be, or it has been so taboo in the past, is that a lot of times there can be really extensive regulations and almost just as many hoops to jump through to get something like that to market, because it is something that you need to just have more care around, because obviously you want to make sure it's the highest quality. So, so I think that's very, very, very cool.
Yeah. One kind of curveball that my co-founder and I ran into is, you know, it's one thing trying to market a sexual product, but trying to market a sexual product that has CBD in it is extremely difficult. So, you know, like we can't put ads on Facebook. We can't actually put ads, you know, different places. So that's another thing that's been a little tough to kind of get the word out, but I'm so excited and grateful to you for having me on today, because it's just it's a great way to get the word out, you know, and to let people know that there is a product that really was made for women in mind for these specific issues.
Thank you so much for taking time to talk with us today.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.